I was never more at home than I was in battle.
I've done bad things.
My soul is damned. Satan's creatures will take me should I stray from the path of peace. I have renounced violence.
What I like so much about Kane is that he is a determined, committed, powerful character.
He's greedy, cold, vicious, hard-hearted, quite prepared to shoot his own men in the back if they run away.
I said, hold steady.
He comes face to face with the Devil's Reaper, who has come to claim his soul and take him to hell. Solomon manages to escape, but there, from then on, he's absolutely terrified that the devil is going to come and get him again. So he starts on a traveling journey. He meets various people. The first people he meets is a good Puritan family.
Pilgrim! Offer you a ride.
Thanks, friend, but no.
Well, the road ahead should not be travelled alone.
Puritan decided to sell up completely all his goods and chattels with his family and is travelling towards Plymouth in order to take ship to the New World. Just happens to encounter Solomon Kane on the way, and wherever Solomon Kane is, things happen.
Samuel, get back to the car. Go on.
An evil force has taken over the land, and nobody really knows who it is or why it is, but it's an evil, bad force. They capture the family. The girl escapes. But Solomon promises the father that he will find the girl and rescue her. And the father, who is a very, very religious man, says, if you manage to find her, and if you rescue her, your soul will be redeemed. And so it becomes a story of redemption, really. It becomes a story of a man trying to find his innocence again.
Have you seen this girl? No, no, look at it, please! Have you seen this girl?
It's a very particular character that Howard created there. Unlike any of the other characters within his oeuvre, we know the muscle-bound characters and the Conans and the Coles, but Kane was one of his very early characters, his most powerful character, most complex character.
If I kill you, I am bound for hell. It is a price I shall gladly pay.
It's an original story by me, hopefully in the style of Howard, with due respect to Howard and his character. I mean, I don't want to create somebody new. I want to create the best version of Kane that could possibly go on screen. We know who he is. We know what a bad, bad man he was. We know the punishment he's got in store. And the fact that he's doing anything to redeem himself seems to make the perfect character arc for me. And of course, then you drop James Purefoy into the mix and he's delivering a fairly astonishing performance.
First day we saw the dailies, we all look at it and we say, yeah, he's Kane. There is no doubt about that.
But I've made a fantasy movie with proper drama, and I've not cheapened it. I've made it better. And I've done service to Robert Howard's original vision as well.
Come on.
There are many paths to redemption, not all of them peaceful.